Welcome back. The President of the Republic, His Excellency Sheikh Professor Al-Haji Dr. Yahya Ejeje Jame Bable Mansa, has returned to Banjul after attending the 13th Summit of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation held in Istanbul, Turkey. The summit brought together leaders from over 30 countries in the Islamic world for 3 days of discussions on issues affecting Islamic countries. After the usual airport ceremonies, Professor Jame spoke to waiting journalists. Here's an excerpt.
Excellency, and I would just like to thank you on behalf of my colleagues for giving us this opportunity and also welcome you back home where you've just attended the 13th OIC summit. It has been a very successful summit given the discussions and the conclusions. Among other things, they affirmed the OIC support to the Palestinians and also confirmed Gambia's hosting of the summit in 2018 and other developments that happened. How would you describe the summit?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله رب العالمين The communique alone is not enough. It's just a piece of paper, to be quite honest. Saying that we are committed to this and that, yes, is one thing. But actual implementation of it is when I will tell you whether it's successful or not. Because if I say I'm going to turn Gambia into a mega city, and people say, that's a wish list. But if I implement it, then it becomes successful. If I don't implement it, then it's just paper talk, do you understand? Now, the Islamic Ummah, there is nothing that would prevent the Islamic Ummah from doing anything we want, because this is the wealthiest, you have most of the world's wealthiest countries and individuals as members of the OIC. But you find amazing, degrading, sinful starvation, poverty, and destitution in the among OIC member states. Now, look at, for example, look at the issue of the refugees. Europe has to raise billions of dollars for Syrian refugees to be able to live some sort of modicum way of life. Not very decent, but not very bad. Where is the Islamic Ummah? Where is the OIC? After all, what is also amazing is the fact that those who set Syria on fire, when they started setting it on fire, every week you have meeting of friends of Syria. Now there's a catastrophe. Those so-called, since the refugee crisis started, in the year of a conference of friends of Syria, where are they? Now, so this is a lesson to all people. That they said they are telling you to burn your house, and when you have nowhere to sleep, you will not go anywhere near their compound. And that is a lesson for all. And that is why everybody should make sure that such people are not spared. Now, cooperation, economic cooperation. There are countries that have done very well in terms of economic cooperation with non-Arab countries. One that stands out is Kuwait. The Kuwait Fund has been in all countries, be it Asia, Southeast Asia, Africa, and others. You go anywhere, you find where the Kuwait Fund has made a lasting impact. Kuwait is not the richest country among the OIC member states, but the impact, positive impact of Kuwait assistance is well manifested, not only in the elsewhere, but particularly in the Gambia. And I always thank them at such summit, because if Allah says that if somebody has been benevolent to you, you should be grateful to him, because otherwise you cannot even be grateful to Allah. If you cannot thank human beings, then you cannot be grateful to the Almighty Allah. So, yes, these are lofty ideas of what we are going to do. For me to tell you that, yes, it's successful, is when we start actual implementation of the outcome. I thank our member state for the support for the hosting of the OIC in Banjul. But remember that decision was taken and put into the final communique in Cairo, not yesterday or the day before yesterday. It took 2 years, it was on 2 years ago. And actually there was no debate about it because it was already in the final communique in Cairo. But I thank member states for the support. And I depend on the Almighty Allah for whatever we achieve in this country. I'm not counting on anybody. I'm counting only on the Almighty Allah for whatever we are going to do in this country. Because it's only the Almighty Allah that can give you what you want, and that is what I'm banking on. For 21 years, we have been successful without any media assistance from countries that will dictate to you. There is one big mouth country. From 94 to date, they have not even given us $50,000. Do you know that? Even when there was the food crisis in this country, others pledged. When the ambassador said she has at least $50,000 to give, because that is at the discretion of the ambassador, she was kicked out of the country and sent to Haiti. So Ghana should not be fooled by these people that do not want any developed African country. Ghana will be the exception. No matter what they do, this country will always be peaceful. Yes. So, but Ghana should also be, what is your return? Since 1994, they have not given us even $50,000. And they are the ones who are talking about democracy. But in their own country, blacks have been shot like dogs. And they want to tell us about democracy. They are killing people more than 20,000 kilometers from that area. And these are people who do not even have ID cards in the desert. They say they are a threat to their national security. So we should leave our national security to the dogs. It's not going to happen. Also, I want to thank Gambians for the exceptional welcome. But when I say Gambians, I mean women and youth, because those are the ones I found here. And those are the people I should thank.
Monument to give President Jammeh a rousing welcome as he returned from the just-ended Organization of Islamic Cooperation Summit in Turkey. The warm welcome was meant to reaffirm their support to the head of state, as well as showcase the importance of peace and stability, which the Gambia is renowned for. Here's an excerpt.
Of this country, specifically those in the Greater Banjul area, feel it very fitting for us to come out as usual to show our solidarity, our loyalty, our sincerity to the head of state.
No, we don't believe in anything other than peace. This country, only peace. And the other thing I want to say, the television stations that are equally taking out images of that little people, let them do the same thing. Let them see the people are in need with President Jammeh. It's only President Jammeh they love in this country. That's all.
Because as you are aware, it is the president who has made the young people of the country to believe in themselves in terms of empowerment, in terms of employment, in terms of employability, and in terms of education. You are all aware that it is His Excellency who gave the Gambian youth the greatest gift of life, that is the University of the Gambia. Thus educate her citizenry in ensuring that her human capacity, you see, what we are saying is, the young people of this country are no more fools, and they are appreciative of what His Excellency has done for them, in ranging from agriculture, education, health, infrastructure, and all spheres of development.